my fellow soulmates here on the University of Planet Earth. Check me out. Prime Up International. www.primeupintl.com. Contact me. Go to www.soulticekarmicrecall. Soul Ties, KarmicRecall.com. Soul Ties, KarmicRecall.com. David Demetri, PUD. Facebook. Yashmal Zero, Instagram. Check out, join David Demetri Records on YouTube.com. David Demetri Records. Join me. I want to enlighten you on what's deeply going on. Love every time. Looking a person in their eyes, you could be looking into their soul. We all have souls. What is that? The energy of the consciousness that can experience, feel, and envision, and think, and imagine? Could the soul exist without the physical body? These metaphysical thoughts in dealing with the common sense reality, in dealing with the mathematical physics reality, metaphysical physics. So look, I want to think about our struggle as human beings. A lot of you out there are liberationists, whether you call yourself that or not, because you want to liberate the planet Earth, the university of the planet Earth. A place where souls come to learn and to teach. Well, I feel that our indulgence into the problems that we have in seeking solutions, in regretting the problems, in fighting against the lies that cause the problems, the misgivings, the disinformation, misinformation that caused the problems, the harmful energies and harmful intent by human beings and souls that cause the problems. I think it's a matter of the calculator. Not just the calculation, not just the outcome, not just the actions taken that cause the outcome, but the calculator and the calculation. Humans miscalculate. And when you're dealing with so many human beings, it's awesome if many human beings can calculate properly together in dealing with the reality to create an altruistic outcome benefiting not only them but all other sentient being kinds on the earth, in those creating an environment and opportunities for those to come on earth in the future that they can enjoy the best of life. Let's address this issue. 2017, January, United States of America, city, California state. Social media is rampant. Addiction to social media. Governments are corrupt. World bankers heartless. Investor class silly and selfish. Rich, middle class, or poor. Doesn't matter. You have the spirit of suffering, of the spirit of deception, and the spirit of jealousy and envy rampant. White human being, black. The same theme is going on. Misinterpretations of reality, disinformation and misinformation and lies about reality. This has caused thousands of years of suffering souls to hope and wish for a solution. Let's look into this metaphysically, quantum physically, on the potentiality in dealing with the worries that we have. A monetary system called an economic system, which is not that because it's preserving nothing. 1970s, peak oil proven to exist. Not until the 2000s did it even really get contradicted with arguments, which really make those that contradict the potential of peak oil seem pitiful and petty. Because their only real argument is that oil can never run out. There is nothing in the physical world that is infinite. I would hope anyone perceiving this is not a buffoon. So with this in mind, we know that all civilizations ended, not only on this planet and any other planets, for those of us that are aware, once the energy source of which all those sentient beings on this earth called humans, the Mayan civilization, which was heralded by the Africans, who were called by the Europeans and Mayans Olmecs, but called themselves something different. Those people started that civilization and used and bred a hybrid form of energy through a food source called, now known and called corn in English, known as maize. That civilization crumbled. The Kemetic civilization in ancient Egypt used rice, a hybrid, corn, maize, and garlic. That civilization came to its end. To think that petroleum, used as the energy source, can keep in being misused, knowing that peak oil ended in the 70s, is that it will never run out, is foolish. We already know that it's running out. We have no idea, and only those in denial would think they're being told the truth by corporations and governments. Because no one in the world tells anyone how much money they have. Even if they give some sort of summary of what their income and net worth is, they will purposely always, if they can, put false information out for self-protection and preservation. And I would do the same, probably, if I had to. But if it's safe, I'll just tell the truth. Nothing telling the truth is the safe thing. But will you tell the truth to yourself with me giving this revelation? Think futurism. And in doing so, you think of the past. Think of movies like, look at the current problems. They're no different than the past. Different players, the same principles, the polarizations, all being dealt with by the human race. We're hoping for the best, those of us that are the sufferers. Those that are causing the suffering seem to be on a race and going a direction where they needed an escape. That is what this civilization, global one world civilization under one monetary system, under one technological control, being powered by one energy source, petroleum energy. And you say, well, there's alternative energy. What is he talking about? Anyone that has taken the time out to study knows that all technology, including this camera, which was made by petroleum products, petroleum technologies, sculpted the lenses, put this microphone together, all the wires were coiled together and wrapped in petroleum-made rubber. All machinery is made and controlled. Electricity is being conducted by machines that are controlled and powered by electricity, which are controlled by energies that and technology that is empowered and put together in the parts created by petroleum, fossil fuels. 75, that peaked out. There was nothing to get. Fracking is pathetic. You're not getting enough out of fracking to do anything. And then if you want to create new technology to create energy, solar, nuclear, or whatnot, are you aware that you're using petroleum, fossil fuel based technology. So how much of that is being used to power these technologies to create this nuclear, to create this solar, to, you understand, use this water at the dam to create this electricity to fuel only the dam itself, because there's not enough electricity to fuel even the local community, let alone the city down in the valley. We are not aware of some vital important things because we're so distracted with entertainment, technology, with our own interpersonal karma and relationships. And so we participate in these things, not realizing, yet we complain and we want solutions. But what if there's another view that we are supposed to be living out and fixing this karma, personal karma, some of us, while others fall into the traps of life, tarnish their souls by harming others and turning the living life of harming others? But what if the world elite are that? The people that control the monetary system that created it, which is but, and it could be argued, it's just a holographic illusion of which all of us are participating in creating, but really they who have established it. But then we have to look at the timeline. Before capitalism, there was something that capitalism named, but it was already a reflection in action by human beings acting it out. Colonization, global colonization, global imperialism, globalization. Henry Ford getting the idea from Garver or Washington, the brother, the black African-American, who found out about the assembly line, which Ford called it, but Washington taught him that. And so many times you see Washington, who is only credited by the European and the white Americans as in that establishment, not white American humans, but that establishment. They only want to give Washington his credit for being creative with foods like peanuts and whatnot. But you need to accept the truth that he is who gave the idea to Henry Ford to come up with mass production and what you call the assembly line. Don't be petty. Don't feel bad. It's no one's fault that you were in the dark. That's who you are in the world. But you don't have to be. Get these ideas of which I'm going to say could be the source cause of all of this. Because all of it is symptoms. The illusion that white and black people are fighting is holographic. All those souls feel the suffering of it. It's an illusion. Time is what we live in. Only if we want to measure the travel, the distance from one point to another. Thus, we have to see this as a long time agenda. 2017, January, I'm sitting here in this many videos as you see on social media and you take for granted and it means nothing to you. And you might want to be the ones listened to and you want to be the one that people are posting your video and you want the attention and you want people to care for you and give you attention. You want to be smarter than me or whatever. Guess what? You are. You are. Yet, I want to share something with you. That's specially for you. That's why you have the opportunity to receive this information and revelation. We're living in a time loops, within loops, within loops, not timeline. Think metaphysical, think quantum physical. I just talked about the world and symptoms and the suffering. Like it or not, more human beings on earth are suffering than they are joyful. It's so much confusion, but human beings are so positive, more positive than negative. Clearly, Uruta is self-destructive long ago. But this is a long time plan. And I want to put things in a perspective for you that some of you realize. But will you share this with your teenager? Will you share this with your child? Or will your religion stop you? Or will you ignore it? It's all over. Who cares? The youth don't need to hear this. Or I don't need to hear this. I already know. It doesn't matter just what you know. What are you living for? What are you devoted to? Do you meditate? Do you dreamscape? Do you astral travel? Do you have a purpose to your astral travel and your dreams? Are you fulfilling your purpose on earth? Are you beyond the stories and themes that were told to you in your conscious mind? And are you living on accord with the new opportunity for new information that you can live up to a higher potential in your interaction with reality and those in the reality you live? That's why this is important, to understand we're in a time loop within time loops within time loops. What if your soul is in multiple bodies, and when you sleep, you actually go into that body? Or whether you sleep or not, you go into that body, and that what happens here affects there, and there affects here. What if certain things you do and put your time, mind, energy into is stopping you from fulfilling your real purpose here, and you will have to repeat this over and over again? Wouldn't you rather get this done once? Don't you feel you're worth that? Do you think these world champion athletes have plenty of times every 4 years, the Olympics, plenty of times they go for that world championship match, for that team sport victory, or for that acting job, that audition, that opportunity to be in that movie and to perform at your greatest to get an Oscar and to make millions of dollars? How about those of you that simply are making it out of the worst situation in life and you just have an opportunity to go get your GED? Opportunity to get out of prison and to live good. An opportunity to say, no, I'm not going to smoke crack today. I'm not going to do methamphetamines today. I'm kicking this heroin. I'm kicking this alcohol. I'm not going to be in live a lie. I know some truth and I'm not going to be a religious freak anymore. And I'm not going to let my religious freak family or whoever control my mind. Well, I want to share something with you. We're all living in a loop. Time loop within time loops. Without time loops. Without time loops. Within time loops. Time could be repeating. Or souls can be getting sent back. And that's what, when the Hindus say that we're in an experiment, the Hindus and Buddhists and even ancients of Africa, we're living in a reality where souls are recycled. Or what this soul couldn't do, another soul will come and do. Time loops. Reincarnation and karma. Find your purpose and meaning. Fulfill that. Leave the rest behind. Love yourself. Believe in you. All right, check it out. Time loops. This is a symbol of ancient Kemet, ancient Egypt to a lot of you. I'm speaking to any human being that hears this. That ancient civilization brought so much unparalleled information to this planet. What if the people that started that civilization did not originate from this planet or dimension? Have you ever heard of interplanetary travel? Well, what if I tell you there's interdimensional travel? And what if I tell you, yes, there's time travel? You have the right to deny this and even deny the importance of it in your life. But I'm granting you an opportunity to embrace that there could be interdimensional traveling trade time travel trade, interdimensional travel, friendships and relationships, time travel friendships and relationships, interdimensional travel war, time travel war. And I will tell you, with the looks and the kinds of this technology even recording me, and that you interpreting this and seeing this message recording me, that this technology is obviously from the true evidence from the archaeological sites and the archaeological proof of the historical civilizations of the past on the planet Earth, that a lot of this technology is new. Now, amidst the use of electricity isn't new. In ancient Kemet, and I firmly believe that was hundreds of thousands of years ago, if not at least 100,000 years ago. But I've seen evidence in the archaeological revelations down there that they used electricity. And even in Samaria, now known in that area as Iran, Iraq, all that, it was proof that in the archaeological finds that there was devices that used electricity. Machines, like the camera recording, like the phone you're holding to watch this, like the computer you're watching this on. So that banishes the lie that we're taught to the older generation. So share this truth with your children and the teens. So in thinking this and realizing, why would this technology be expounding on us now if just 100 years ago, 150 years ago, we didn't even have vehicles? We had vehicles, but they were wagons being pulled by animals or humans. Yes, humans. Black people were forced to do what the animals had to do to benefit whites in the United States of America, and Indians in India, and Asians, and everybody just agreed for some reason to make anybody black they got darker skinned a slave. Not my problem. Not my responsibility. I would have been enslaved. So I got the right to speak on it. I think anybody has the right to speak on it. It has nothing to do but anything, but the point I'm trying to make is that look at this technology we're living in. We have flying vehicles. Ancient civilizations had flying vehicles. I've seen the proof on the archaeological sites and multiple, and not just documentaries, but by going to archaeological sites myself. And seeing this evidence, we need to really rationalize how the influence of Hollywood and movies make us think. And then the desensitization from as a child watching these screens, putting it out there, it takes away the fact that for the last, since the Inquisition and since the colonization and imperialization of the Roman Empire, the Greek Empire, going out and destroying all the ancient civilizations and saying no one can survive and no one can tell what the way things used to be. And that was called the Dark Ages. That was when the Roman Catholic Inquisitions disallowed human beings anywhere where white people have power, and the white race itself, the European race itself, told itself it would not let themselves, especially, and anyone else, teach about anything other than what that current European paradigm accepted as a reality and a truth. So which means authority was the power, truth, and authority decided what was true and not, and what history was and not. Not truth decided what was real and not, and what the history was. So in other words, the entire world, the entire European race was lied to, and usually whoever can get the truth and that was in the right status, the right family and whatnot, could live a better life than all the others who would be considered, they were considered gentry, the others were considered serfs, slaves. And so they took this mentality, and all the other peoples of the world that were indigenous and pretty much living in peace, Africans didn't even have physical war with each other in Southern Africa. They just danced against each other. So can you imagine the difference from these brutal people proud, and some of you who are proud with your guns you own and you hope and wish you could shoot somebody one day, you're sick. You should wish not to have to. If nothing wrong with owning a gun, I own a gun. But I'm saying I don't ever want to have to use it. I have a better mentality than that. I wish a pure happy life and I have a pure heart. And so what I'm saying with this time going by, it was a huge lie to the human race. When I was a child, they lied and told us that electricity was found on a kite and a key by Benjamin Franklin. That is pathetic. And these lies were perpetuated. People are getting credit for inventions they didn't even invent. People that invented things are being murdered and killed. Archaeological finders that find the bones of giants, all these findings to prove that electricity was used are being killed. Their whole lives, careers, they can't even work in their field anymore because they want to tell the truth. It's a reason. Because they don't want us to value understanding the power of time. Time is a record. We're the interpreters. We're the perceivers. Like in quantum physics, that experiment, if you perceive it, you change it. So if we perceive this truth for what it is just in our minds, then we feed it to our children, then we change the reality so war could end. We change the reality so that, so basically souls are being sent here, not just from the past, like reincarnation is being taught in Hinduism and Buddhism, but souls are being sent here by from the what we would perceive as the future. Did I just hurt you? Or did I just free you? Did I just help you? Your destiny here could be to be a liberationist, a freedom fighter, a truth acceptor, because denial is rampant. The human race is in a state of amnesia, self-denial, and perpetual vibrating self-hate, confusion, and despair. Fear and anger are rampant, a plague. I wish us all the best in liberation from this. And those of you that are liberationists and even already thinking on this level, we must teach the truth of the importance of time, interdimensional travel. That's right. Our souls can be reincarnating from other planets of which we've already did what the Buddha and what Jesus and what the Jedi did, and we evolved to higher planets. But we chose to come back. Or we were sent back. And we don't have to be famous and known. We don't have to be known as Che or Malcolm X or Martin Luther King or any of these people that fought for freedom. We don't have to be famous revolutionaries that pick up the gun and sword, but we could be truth bearers. Standing for the truth. That smoking a cigarette is going to destroy your life. And when that child see you do that, you're telling another adult that, and other adults in there like, why are you telling us not to drink? Get up out of here. That child sees it. So that child gets a couple of years older and say, I remember that person was like this. I want to be like them. I don't want to do that. So while everybody else think little of you, and that you're nothing, you're still poor as them, but they remember that you had stood up against that. And that's why they don't totally like you. But now they want to be like you. Most important is that child turned out to be like you and better. I commend you all, and I hope you can understand that this time thing and this truth thing is of vital importance. So what we are living in is a time loop. Dimensions are interceding because we're the perceivers. We're the interpreters. We're the actors. We are that time. We are that dimension coming here. We represent that. And that's why it seems that there's the evil and the good. There's the vibration of that causes suffering and despair. There's the vibration that causes compassion and love. And they're fighting against each other. Let's go in even deeper and look specific. In a way where some people will be hurt. specifically the black people and white people, and those of you that are in between and mixed that want to claim that, well, I like the blacks more or I like the whites more, that's not what you're here for. And that's not why you're mixed. You need to grow up. You have an opportunity here. Whether you're about compassion and love is what matters, or if you're about suffering and despair. There are souls that wake up out of the stupor. And this is the stupor. A lot of you might not like this. Some of you are like me for it. There was a time and there was a war. There are interdimensional travelers that folded space that came here. They came here in the way they did. Time ships. And once they got here, then they can reproduce. And that's the reincarnation. But they came here in time interdimensional traveling machines. Or they were sent here from machines and they just appeared. And then they can reproduce their spirit in this world by reproducing, mating with those that were already here. And they were of suffering. These beings caused suffering, deception, lies, trick knowledge, politricking. That's all capitalism is. It's a head game, it's a play game so that we, whoever we are, stay in power. So let's create these masses of people. Can you imagine this plan been going? Think about how long ago this man, Adam Smith, wrote what he observed in world markets and industries. And then he put it down on paper of how it go, and then how we could do this with all the other, and we can create this worldwide. And then here come the religion applied to it, manifest destiny. They create God as a man and then tell you that God was a man and that he was a white man in Africa, because the Middle East was barely called the Middle East after World War I. I'm kicking facts. So what we have to realize is you mix all this trick knowledge. You got these people who were teaching their own people lies so they can motivate them, mobilize, organize them to go out in the world, brutalize other people, bring disease, because mostly their diseases that were on their bodies killed off millions. They genocided people. This ain't about the white race. Let's not be fooled. All of them, listen, it's not about the race. Let's say this is not even about Earth. Let's say this happened on another plane, some moon on a world with people that were, it was just a water world and they lived under the water. These people came from a planet where there was just land and they came and they caused suffering to those in the water. They had to lie to their land people about who they were and what right and wrong was. And then they would motivate them and say, these are the enemies. We have to destroy them. And anybody that disagreed, they brutalized and they built a world like that. But then in doing so, they destroyed their own world. Being nasty and unclean. And so they go and they destroy all that good heavenly abode, those people in that water world. Well, that's what happened on Earth. The Earth dwellers have been crushed and then colonized on this planet by beings from somewhere and sometime else. And that's who's doing this to us. No matter what race you are, if you're a human being, a sentient being, an indigenous nature, we're in compassion and love is most important. You need to accept this truth that we've been lied to and that these beings are running this world and controlling this world. And so when you hear this talk about aliens and all this stuff, that's playing with the truth to confuse you in the movies and whatnot, to confuse you. But I refer you to a movie called They Live. And you need to tell this to your children and to your teenagers. You need to take time out for this. And during the holidays, make sure that this is something you keep putting in each other's head. time travel wars, interdimensional travel wars. So they came here and they took over, they created a breed of soldier people who had no conscience of what they did to others. And the only way to do that is to have them socialize that to each other. So what society only in the world in history originated the practice of raping their males to get them to be vile, vicious killers and to go out and kill in war? The Greeks and the Caucasus mountain people. Reason, and the same people ate people if there was nothing else to eat. By all means necessary, had all kind of worms and diseases on their bodies. Wherever they went, they destroyed them. The American natives, not just them. The Africans were just wiped out by diseases that the Europeans brought to them. I'm not saying anything wrong. I'm not talking anything but about the truth. Because for us to fix this, we need the righteous, pure Europeans to fight with us. This is not about race. This is about time loops. This is about interdimensional travel. But this is a story that's played out that got us to where we are in 2017, January, where I am now. So what I'm saying is we need to understand that as a human being, regardless of our race, creed, color, religion, and all that, these are facts. Then they keep kicking lies and putting out these agendas, and they put themes in people's minds so people live their lives for these goals of that are hurting and destroying other people. And it keeps going, it's keep going, it keep going. So anything that you're telling yourself about politics, Donald Trump, how he's in alignment with the British agenda against immigration, then you have the movie that was a subliminal movie about that, Children of Men, and how they created a virus that stopped people from having babies. But why would they do that? Because the fact is, here in 2017, the Europeans are at a zero reproduction rate in Europe. You get it? This means that this will be the time that them create, the elite can create that disease. Why? To wipe out the brown and black. The elite whites have to counter react. And the fact that their skin is white has nothing to do with this. That has to do with it for them. But for those of us that are white, black, or any of us that are indigenous, the Irish are indigenous human beings, and this and this and this, and all these, and that's why they were so dogmatically enslaved and abused. And then they were turned into slave masters, and they enslaved us blacks in America because of their whites. So they are the modern day proof of what the whites did to each other if they were righteous. That's how we know there's righteous white people. And so this message is for us all. And so what I'm saying is, this agenda is an agenda. And reason why the lie fighting the truth, and those of us holding the faith for the truth, this is what the war is. They're sending people from the past and from the future here to destroy us, the indigenous humans. They're sending technology. You getting it? They're not just using these machines like on Terminator when they just appear during electricity. That too. Oh, that's going on. But see, they've been quarantined here. They quarantined themselves. So they're limited. And the time's limited. But nothing will happen unless the prophecy's fulfilled. And I don't like to use that word because I'm not, in a sense, bulimia and sterile, superstitions or anything, or religions or anything. What I'm trying to get to you in reality is we need to wake up and take responsibility. And wherever we're at, fight for the truth and fight for what's right where we're at. Yes. But some of us got to take sacrifices, and those of us in the masses got to quit looking down and think we know what's going on. Oh, he went crazy. Christopher Donner, the black cop in California, went crazy. They had to kill him in Big Bear. Don't you know he was whistleblowing? So obviously he was going to whistleblow again. You understand? The because there's a higher agenda. And that's just a small thing. But you have to understand, like in the movie They Live, that guy moved, that Roddy Ryder played his part, he worked his way up so that he can destroy their electrical grid that was connected with their satellite that had frequency warfare mind control over the masses on the earth. And when he broke that signal, people could see who the evil or who the interdimensional travelers were, who were of that bloodline or of that spiritual existence, who were masquerading around as if they were indigenous human beings from Earth, but really they are not. That's real. That's what's going on. That's what has to be done. So where's the technology? Where is it? There's obviously technology. Stargates being used, frequency warfare being used, time loop. There's, and this is what we need as indigenous people to communicate back with those that we are out of touch because we've been quarantined. Those that came here quarantined us. That we can't communicate with those of us that have the power to come fight them. And so they're probably sending us here, but we have to wake up. We have to remember. So you living your life, you need to remember. Look, long ago, I realized something about life. When I meet people and I go through things, I've already been through that. I already know this person. I'm remembering them. I'm not just meeting them. I have to fulfill this. I have to do my part. Reincarnation or recall. Soul Ties Karmic Recall. My book series. Soul Ties. I have a karmic recall. This whole planet's story is being replayed out. They act like they know, and this is amazing, they're the only ones doing it. This is a lie. This right here could be ended with a mass awakening. And it's not a moment. It's generational. This one has to become more awoke to whatever, and this one has to be awoke to this, and this, and we all have to keep fulfilling it. And then before you know it, just indigenous people living happy on Earth. Time travel is being used. Stargates. Folding space. I would even say some of ours are coming here and are here using time travel, sending beings here as humans to fight against them. And some of them could be white. Here to fight the evil white people. For those of you that are black, some of them could be black. Some people could be knowing what they're here for, and they weren't born here. This is how deep this is. Some of us could be going backwards in time while we seem to be living forward in time. Because we have to fix something we got wrong. There's so much time loops being here because we are the experiencers. I might just be here because I got this wrong and I didn't love the women right. Where I was a coward and I didn't save the people, or I saved everyone and then for no reason and they ended up blowing it anyway. So now I get to come here and love myself this lifetime and not sacrifice myself for everybody as a martyr. There's a lot of different time loops going on, particularly in this design specific by the soul, because that soul is interpreting like a gene is a gene. You don't need a Bible, you don't need a Quran, you don't need a Vedas. You have the genetic information that tell you who you are inside you as you're born and as you're growing. And if you are in tune with nature, then you resonate in oneness with nature and the sun instead of being a contrary to the sun, then you can do that with nature and live that life out and reincarnate and grow families, a nation. And so then you have the people that can't even stand in the sun. And I've watched black people turn so evil, that are so evil, that can't even stand in the sun. Gotta have them big old black sunglasses on because they done turned so evil. So don't just blame the white people. I'm telling you, this is deep. That's who's controlling this world and putting all these illusions out, and that we can't be focused within to manifest the beauty of life and creation. Instead, we have to be dealing with all this manipulation and ill-gotten manifestations. Yet, if you're ignorant and just call yourself a fight against evil, or time travel, interdimensional travel, that's too much. I'm just gonna live my life. Or when you're contributing to it. And you don't never discuss it, you don't spend no time on this, you don't even teach this. As much as you love Avram Van Sarma, Dr. Ben, you know what I'm saying? Phil Valentine, you love all these incredible Dr. Clark, you love Malcolm X, Harriet Tubman. You know what? That's why a soul was sent from the future like Bobby Hemming. A soul was sent from the future like Phil Valentine, like Jewel Pulchram, to come wake us up to the higher levels. But we need to make masses of human beings. What's this teacher? Michael Wilcox. He's a teacher and he's bringing the truth. We need masses of human beings to listen to these teachers. You got people trying to wake people up. But we have to take it and we say, well, what does this pertain to my little life here? It's because you might be the one just like that little Roddy Piper when he acted that part out in the movie They Live. He was a homeless nobody. Couldn't even take care of a family. But he ended up, because he had nothing to lose, and he went out and fought, and he made that black man, because black people are conservative, because it's some writers, listen, he made that black man wake up and put them glasses on. He sat there and fought them. They fought, and he made that black man put them glasses on. That black man seen the truth. That everyone was being brainwashed and mind controlled. That these beings were walking around that look human but ain't really. And why would he have to do that to a black man? Because the black human race is the key. But they've been so abused by these people who infiltrated our planet. They say we gotta keep them down. Not just misuse them and enslave them, but out of all the people on earth, we gotta keep them down. So we gotta mash their brains down and create a world and a problem for them that they can never wake up. And how do you do it? By fear. Fear makes you so conservative. There's a couple, I read this in the 90s. They were called the Hart, H-A-R-T. Look them up. A husband and wife, African-American, wrote a book. In that book, wrote multiple books, I think. In that book I read, remember they said, the reason why black Americans and blacks of the slavery are so conservative is because of fear. It make you conservative, make you religious. It make you everything but free. Just like I respect everybody saying, we need economic freedom, we need economic unity. I've started BERF, the Black Economic Resistance Front, a page on Facebook. So I'm with it. But let me tell you something. One thing black Americans and black people and worldwide are in denial about are is nuclear bomb and the threat of World War III. They're also in denial about the realities of time travel, dimensional travel, and time looping. That is the reason why so many still believe in false religions. With smoking cigarettes, you need to replace it with something else. With smoking cocaine, you need to replace it with something else. So you got to get all these false notions and tell the truth. So this is why, if you see this truth, don't just play yourself and act ignore it. He ain't nobody. Don't worry about me. Get this message out to the youth. This about time travel, about time, interdimensional, and about their importance. Because little by little, I can knock out this frequency. I can knock out this machine with this frequency. And if I knock out the one here in the city of San Bernardino in California, then guess what? Everyone can see who the evil is and the fake humans versus the real humans. And it can be on. Then someone in Detroit do it there, knock it out, then you can see this is a fake human, that's a real human, it can be on. That's how they playing us. You don't know who's a real human. You see where I'm coming from? You are that important. It ain't gonna be the people rich and famous with all that and all this money and so much to lose. Them the suckers that's gonna let us down. Some of them gonna sacrifice. And they very important. And if some of them is sacrificing, reach out to me if you rich and famous. You see what I'm saying. You want me to come talk on your show. If you want me to represent and just meet with you secretly and make some things happen, get with me. I'm not afraid of nothing. But I'm telling you, this is of vital importance. The interdimensional time travel war and the the fact that our world is quarantined and enslaved by interdimensional time traveling entities, conscious entities. Okay? We can call them conscious entities who created an army and sent them out, and they took over the world. They gave them a false history, a false religion and whatnot. But we're living in a real reality. And this reality is getting worse. And it's going to be nuclear war. It's going to be World War III. It's going to be economic crash. All this is part of it. It's going to be a virus created that's going to kill millions of people. But it can be stopped if we can stop these people quarantined, these conscious entities who are taking that are not just in physical form, but that are feeding and controlling the conscious minds of many beings who are their slaves here. This is the real war. This is what's really going on. This is the root cause. We have to stop these. We have to open up our own wormholes and bring our entities in that are going to liberate and free us and fight their entities. And we need to get more of our own warrior beings and warrior technology so we can fight theirs. But the key thing is we need to shut down their technology, which is open there, that they can communicate in the other dimensions and communicate with the other worlds so they can keep the power here. We need to cut that off. Now you see the importance of this? I'm gonna leave it there. You wanna do a video chat back, you wanna communicate in secret, you wanna disagree even, you wanna add ideas, and this is a revolution. And not because of me, this is already here. I was just born into this world. This is a liberation movement. Not because of me, I'm just born in this world. I'm just doing what I was sent back in time to do, that I was sent in this dimension and plane of existence to do. I gotta fulfill my karma, but at the same time, I also gotta do what I gotta do to help liberate this world. So, know that I'm David Dimitri, but I'm also Dauda Asaru. Let's teach this truth. Some of us need to focus on teaching this. Take on the responsibility of teaching about the time travel war, the interdimensional capabilities in war. This is vital importance. Take up on this cause. Focus on it. Put years into it. And put out the message. And come up with ideas and solutions and try them. Check me out. Prime Up International. www.primeupintl.com. Contact me. Go to www.soulticekarmicrecall. Soul Ties. KarmicRecall.com. Soul Ties Karmic Recall.com. David Dimitri PUD. Facebook. Yashmal Zero Instagram. Check out, join David Dimitri Records on YouTube.com. David Dimitri Records. Join me. I want to enlighten you on what's deeply going on. Love every time.